Dhammataya tanto dhammante no vatranaya sa Nibuddho nibbanataya tan lokatranami Lokatrano lokatumba ipuzaya tasu pshito mudo Yo nago buddha naga miro yadhyā sindhi yato tachinya swapyādi Buddha tisali inkuro raito twenty miyano mubi pshayue Bodhāya sa chatai tātu bhupodu rukutu ten lenti jābhāze jencho ngālagao Tanto kuro ga bhin yin chi do mu yi pye yue Dhammata ya sa chutai ta tu bu bu lu ro kutu me yin yin chi cha si ching a le gao Tanto kurai ga bhin ki li ta u pu ka te yin yin do mu yi pye yue Dhammata ya sa chutai ta tu bu bu lu ro kutu me yin ki li ta pu nyin ja pa si chin a le gao Dino wa tandeya na wangare chanko Kutan to chao kuro ran yao pi pi Karanaya sa kuro
Thank you. ဒါကြောင့်ယအကုန်ကောင်းကျိုးချမ်းသာကြကြကုန်နေပြီဝေဘုဒ္ဓသာသနာဘုဒ္ဓမြတ်စွာသံဃာတော်များကျွေးတဲ့ဝိရုဏမညာပုညာနိဗ္ဗာန်ရည်ကြုံတည်စီကကြီးဝါကြီးကြကုန်နေပြီဝေဒုက္ခိတာကိုစဉ်းကြံပြန်ရင်းချမ်းသာခြင်းတို့ရည်ကြကုန်နေပြီဝေအဘိဓိဝိမေပါပဲဥဒ္ဒေသံခန္ဓာကိုယ်တော်လုံးသောဘုဒ္ဓညာဤပြည့်စုံသောဘုဒ္ဓနေသာသူတို့ဘုရား အရောကနာရောကဒုက္ခကိဝေကြကုန်သည်ဒုက္ခိတာကိုစဉ်းကြံပြန်ရင်ချမ်းသာခြင်းရှိကြကုန်သည်ဘောဓာဖြစ်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်းအဘမင်္ဂလံကိုစဉ်းချမ်းသာခြင်းအကြောင်းကောင်းများသောခန္ဓာအသောလုံးသောမင်္ဂလာပေါင်းသည့်ဘောဓာဖြစ်ပါစေသတည်းအဘဒီဝိတ္တခန္ဓာကိုယ်တော်များနဲ့ကောင်းအပေါင်းတို့သည်ရက္ခဏတို့အမြဲတမ်းဆောင်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်း ဘဗုဒ္ဓံဘဝိနကိင္ခဝါလူသေသမကပုဗ္ဗရောဉ္ဇတိဘုံတော်သတိဥသောလောဇောဘုံတော်ဘုရားရှင်တို့၏သဘောတိသောအနုဘောကြောင့်ဘဗုဒ္ဓံဘဝိနခန္ဓာဥသောလောဇောဘုံတော်ဘုရားရှင်တို့၏ဘုံတော်ကိုအာယုံကြည်၍ညှိုးရသာကုသကံစေနာ၏ဒီဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်သဗ္ဗဓမ္မာနုဘဝိနမေဖို့နိဗ္ဗာန်တမေကဟုခေါ်စွာသောကတိဥသောလောဇောဘုံတော်ဘုရားရှင်တို့၏ဒီဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့် ဘဗ္ဗံဓမ္မနုဘဝိနမေဖို့နိဗ္ဗာန်တမေကဟုခေါ်စွာသောခန္ဓာကိုယ်သောလုံးလုံးသောတရားတော်များတို့၏ကိုယ်ကိုအယုံကြည့်၍ညီညွတ်သောကုသကံစေနာ၏ဒီဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်သဗ္ဗသံဃာနုဘဝိနခန္ဓာဥသောလုံးလုံးသောအရိယသံဃာရောမြတ်သောဒီဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်သဗ္ဗသံဃာနုဘဝိနခန္ဓာဥသောလုံးလုံးသောအရိယသံဃာရောမြတ်သောဒီဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့် Yadi nam gada bada galam nam go damana vidikam bavariya.
Getting amongst the end of rain's retreats. On this occasion, the devotees come together to offer robes to the community of Sangha. As the offering of Gatina robes is Sangikadana, then it is considered one of the greatest meritorious activities by So we here teach first anapana to and attend Kasina at age of 10 years. And then we teach not yet supernatural power, but we know and see ultimate mentality and activity, which are the first noble truth. But I will not teach any tradition, but I will teach the way the Buddha taught. To make all of you understand clearly, let me explain a little bit more. Buddha taught three trainings, the training of morality, the training of concentration, and the training of insight. You know, what is the training of morality? For about the training of concentration, you need to know that the Buddha taught 40 kinds of meditation objects, and among 40, 30 leads to absorption, and the rest helps to excess concentration. For about the serenity practitioners, they must first develop absorption concentration. After that, we need to continue the training of insight. When the Buddha taught the thought training, how many meditation objects the Buddha taught? Materiality meditation, mentality meditation. Okay? When the Buddha taught rupa meditation, Buddha taught 4 minutes meditation in brief or detailed method. So, after having developed absorption, concentration, the serenity practitioners need to continue 4 elements meditation to know and see the ultimate materiality. So when they practice 4 elements meditation after having developed Anabana Phocchana. Finally, they can break the body down into very tiny small particles. And they need to analyze ultimate materiality exists in each particle. After that, they need to continue ultimate. They need to continue mentality meditation to know and see ultimate mentality. Then we continue teaching meditators to know and see causes and effects. At that time, they are ready to proceed insight meditation. Okay, this is not a tradition. This is the way taught by Buddha. That's why those who could practice, they appreciate very much, oh, now we are practicing what the Bodhisattva had practiced, what the Buddha had practiced, what many of his disciples had practiced, not part of method. If you emulate the way the Bodhisattva practiced for his enlightenment, it is also possible for you to practice here. I will teach you that.
Today, I would like to explain about heavenly orientation.
오늘은 연기에 대해서 말씀을 드리겠습니다.
One day, when a river Ananda was practicing in Annapurna forest, together with our Lord Buddha, while discerning poets in this way, dependent origination patterns are very clear to his mind. He approached to the Buddha in the evening. Then he informed to the Buddha, Pandey, dependent origination is actually very deep and profound. However, it is very clear to my mind. In this way, he informed to the Buddha. At the dying, Buddha says to the Venerable Ananda, you should not tell like that, you should not tell like that. It does Ananda Dhammasa Analu Buddha Abdi Veda. Eva Maya Bhaja Danda Kula Gaja Da Kula Gandhi Gaja Da Moja Pabhaja Buddha Abhaya Dhokade Unipada Sansara Nadi Vodadi. Do you understand?
이해하셨어요?
지금 빨리어도 개성으로 하고 싶은데 이해하셨어요?
Maybe I recite this sutra because this is not my original speech. This is original speech is Buddha's teaching. I want to explain in this way. What is the meaning? Ananda, because of not understanding by direct knowledge this dependent origination, and because of not penetrating by different stages of direct knowledge this dependent origination, all these beings are not escaped from the round of rebirth. They cannot escape from the woeful stage. Couldn't this sutta, especially Visuddhimagga and the Sammoha Vinodini commentary, explains Pavancheka Mabhadale Dava Asani Uchaka Miwa Nicha Nimatana Sansara Bhaya Madido Nagochi Supi Nandri Pyachi. What is the meaning? So the meaning is Samadhi is like a stone. Upon this stone, you must sharpen your wisdom light.
Wisdom?
Light.
Mind.
Light.
Life. 삼례란 부처님께서 이런
What is the meaning? Concentrated mind is the proximate cause of wisdom faculty. If there is no concentration, wisdom faculty cannot work in this fashion. For example, now please pay attention to your body. Can you see Kalapas?
자, 예를 들면 여러분 몸에 주목을 해 보십시오. 깔라파를 볼 수 있나요?
Can you see?
보여요?
No, because you have no concentration. But concentrated mind can see these colors as well as can analyze those colors and can see adimate materiality as well as adimate mentality and as well as their causes, that is dependent origination. Maybe they translate very closely subatomic particles. These clubs are not ultimate materiality. This is the smallest group of materiality. As soon as you see space, then you can see clubs. You must practice four elements meditation if you want to see this space element. What are four elements? Earth element, water element, fire element, and wind element. If you practice four elements meditation systematically, when your concentration deep becomes deep enough, you can see transparent body like ice block because you cannot see space element. If you do not see space element, you cannot break down the compactness. If you cannot break down the compactness, you cannot see kalpa. At that day, Buddha teach to see space. That concentrated mind on the four elements object also produces a strong, powerful light. That light is called the light of wisdom. With the assistance of the light of wisdom, if you penetrate to see space element, at that day you can see space. As soon as you see space, then you can see clubs. If you see four elements in each club, this is the last stage of samatha. Last stage of samatha as well as the beginning stage of vipassana. Because of this reason, this four elements meditation is both sides, samatha and vipassana. If you get these four elements in each particle, each club, then you should continue to discern color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, light quality, transparency, etc. You can easily discern these derivative materialities. Odor, dish, agasa, dhatu, space element. For clear understanding of these derivative materialities, in Sankalpas there are 10 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, light faculty, and eye transparency. In the same way, you should understand ear transparency, nose transparency, tongue transparency, and body transparency. Why they are called transparency? Yakadi incha vidha. Rubadina gahana bhavena. Rubadina gahana vichya bhavena. Adasa talam viya vipassanata pasada rupa. This is the definition given in Visuddhimagga about the purification. But I will explain the meaning. There are five transparent rupas, materialities. So if there is no eye transparency, eye consciousness cannot arise. If eye consciousness cannot arise, then one cannot see color. In the same way, other transparencies are also you should understand in the same way. If there is body transparency, body consciousness arises depending on body transparency. Body consciousness can feel tangible object. In some clubs, there are in the same way, 10 types of materiality, but they are not transparent. They are opaque clubs. There are two important materialities, self-determining materiality and heart base. Heart base is mind base or mind consciousness. That heart base arises depending on inside your heart. There is blood. Depending on that blood, this heart base arises. So altogether, there are different types of derivative materialities. If you can analyze these clubs in this way, at that time only you can understand ultimate materiality. But nowadays, there are many scientists. They do not understand about these clubs completely. What is the reason? In their laboratory, they can test only temperature bomb materiality. According to Buddha's teaching, this group, if we divide these rupas, there are four groups. Number one is kama bhum, materiality. Number two is mind bhum, materiality. Number three is temperature bhum, materiality. Number four is nutriment bhum, materiality. Kama is connected with previous kama, no present kama. Present karma is, if there is any future existence, this is the cause for future material, future five aggregates only. So, to understand this is karma for materiality, we must try to discern five past causes. But these five past causes I will explain later. Every consciousness, which arise depending on heart based, can produce mind bone materiality. So without understanding heart based, without understanding mind consciousness which arise depending on heart based, you cannot discern mind bone materiality. Yeah, please try to see. Oh, Pene Sajay. Which produce this penny? Which produce this sajay? Your mind. That mind is rise dependent on your heart place. That mind produce uncountable mind bone kalapa. These kalapas spread throughout the body. Up to this end, they also spread. So, if you analyze these kalapas, in each kalapa there are eight types of materiality. Among these eight, there is wind element. That wind element again produces bodily intimation. Because of this bodily intimation, new kalapas always rising and passing away. The new kalapas, they cannot rise same place, in the same place. They rise in different place. That different place rising is, you may see this is Bene Sajje. But if you see kalapas, you cannot see this penga. You can see only kalapas. These kalapas, there are eight types. Among eight types, there is bodily intimation. That bodily, because of this bodily intimation, the whole, all rupas, they do not rise the same place. If you do not see this process, then we can say you do not understand mind form materiality. Here is also another consciousness. Here, I consciousness. That I consciousness cannot produce I know materiality. In the same way, here consciousness also cannot produce ear bone, cannot produce mind bone materiality. Nose consciousness also cannot produce mind bone materiality. Tongue consciousness also cannot produce mind bone materiality. Body consciousness also cannot produce mind bone materiality. In the same way, your brain, I want to tell about this. If you can discern four elements in your brain, you can see brain is nothing but a group of kalapas. Among those kalapas, one kalapa is body dekit kalapa. In that body dekit kalapa, there is body transparency. Depending on body transparency, body consciousness can arise. Body consciousness knows only tangible object. That body consciousness also cannot produce mind bone materiality. Depending on that body transparency in your brain, there are eight types of mentality including body consciousness. Among, I will calculate this thing because I have something to tell about this problem. Hmm? Number one, consciousness. Number two, contact. Number three, feeling. This is neutral feeling. Then number four is perception. Number five is volition. Number six is one-pointedness. Number seven is life faculty. Number eight is attention. So all together, eight types of mentalities only. Among these eight types, there is no wisdom faculty. Wisdom faculty arises depending on your heart base only, according to Buddha's teaching. But you can discern practically. So now we have explained karma bond materiality, number two, mind bond materiality, and now number three, temperature bond materiality. What is temperature? In your eye, there is integrated club together with eye transparency. If you analyze, there are 10 types of materiality. Among 10 types, there is fire element. That fire element can produce 4 or 5 generation new clubs. This is temperature bomb materiality. In the same way, in your mind bomb club, if you analyze your mind bomb club, there are in each club, there are 8 types of materiality. But this mind power is very different. Ordinary mind, such as now you are listening or I am talking, such type of mind, listening mind, that fire element can produce 2 or 3 generations only. However, if your mind is like jhana mind or vipassana mind, that mind has strong power. That mind can produce uncountable millions of kalpas. Now many meditators, they can see light here, etc. What is that light? This is the light of wisdom. So how this arises? You are discerning your breath, or you are concentrating on your breath object, or you are concentrating on your nimitta, anapana nimitta. If you can concentrate well, and if your concentration also becomes deeper and deeper, at that time, that concentrated mind associates with wisdom faculty. That wisdom faculty, when this wisdom faculty's power is very strong and powerful, then that mind can produce jhana mind, especially jhana mind, can produce strong, powerful lights, not only internally, but also externally. These colors spread throughout the body. Among those, if one analyze those kalapas, in each kalapa there are 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types, there is color. That color begins luminous and bright. Again, if you analyze those kalapas, in each kalapa there are 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types, there is fire element. That fire element is called temperature. That temperature also produces uncountable many millions of kalapas. Again, if you analyze these kalapas, in each kalapa there are also in the same way 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types there is color. That color also luminous and bright. These temperature burn light not only internally but also up to externally spread. So internal light is both two. Two types is mind bone kalapas color as well as temperature bone kalapas color. Two types of kalapas color. But externally, there is only temperature bone kalapas color only. Depending on concentration, wisdom faculty's power is very strong. When concentration is very deep, wisdom faculty power also very great. When the power of wisdom faculty is very great, then the light of wisdom is very bright. So, scientists, they do not understand this. process of mind bomb materiality as well as temperature bomb materiality. Karma bomb materiality acts only internally, not externally. Mind bomb materiality also arises only internally, not externally. Why they do not arise in external in anime war? As soon as they arise, these klapas, mind bomb materiality as well as karma bomb materiality, as soon as they arise, they pass away very quickly. There is no time to carry from this body to laboratory. Their lifespan is only 70 mind moment only.
70.
Very short. Their lifespan is very short. So they cannot carry up to laboratory. Now every day we are eating. Food is inside our stomach. If a meditator gains the same four elements in that newly eaten food, undigested food, they can see food is nothing but a group of klapas. Throughout our body there are life nonic klapas. Among those life nonic klapas there is fire element. That fire element is called digestive fire. When the digestive fire supports this nutritive essence of newly eaten food, that nutritive essence can produce new generation, new klapas. In laboratory, there is no digestive fire. So because of this reason, they do not understand this nutritive as co-materiality. They can carry only one piece of flesh to the laboratory. If one meditator can descend this piece, which they carry to laboratory, this piece is a group of klapas. If one analyzes these klapas, in each klapa there are eight types of materiality. What is the source? In each klapa there is fire element. That fire element can produce new generation, new klapa. In that new generation there is also again fire element. That fire element again produces another new generation. They can test in their own laboratory this temperature bomb materiality only. They cannot understand, especially in each klapa there are eight types of materiality, because their investigation is in different way. My meaning is we Buddhists are very lucky.
우리 불자들은 아주 운이 좋습니다.
We can, if we practice systematically, we can understand four types of materiality by your own direct knowledge. This is the materiality aggregate only. This is the object of vipassana. If you do not understand this materiality by your direct knowledge, if you practice vipassana, your vipassana is just superficial only.
Alors, moi, je vais
Alors,
So number one, you should try to understand the noble truth of suffering. What is noble truth of suffering? Sankhitina vichu vadana khanda dukkha. This is in the first sammo, Dhamma Chekha Bodhana Sutta. The Dhamma Wheel Turning Emotion Sutta, Buddha Display. In brief, five clinging aggregates are the noble truth of suffering. So, what are five clinging aggregates? The clinging aggregate of materiality, the clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. All together, there are five clinging aggregates. Among these five clinging aggregates, the clinging aggregate of materiality is materiality, rupa. The clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. These four aggregates are mentality, nama. Five clinging aggregates in nama rupa, mentality and materiality are same meaning. So if you want to become noble one, like Sautampanna, Satri Vena, etc. First, you must try to understand the noble truth of suffering. This is Panklinge, Vigas, or Mentality and Materiality, when you are direct knowledge. The among the aggregates I had explained materially aggregate in my previous talk. Then you must continue to discern ultimate mentality. For some meditators who have already practiced jhana practice, they can easily discern this mentality. In one mind moment, for example, like I consciousness mind moment, there are 8 types of mental formations. In some mind moments, like jhana, first jhana concentration, there are 34 mental formations. If the meditator cannot differentiate, this is consciousness, this is contact, this is feeling, this is perception, this is volition, etc., then we cannot say he or she understands mentality. What is Buddha's instruction? Especially in Mahasatipatthana Sutta, four foundations of mindfulness, concrete four foundations of mindfulness, so that Buddha says this system. Iti ijadava kaya kaya nubasi viharati, vahidava kaya kaya nubasi viharati, ijadava vahidava kaya kaya nubasi viharati. What is the meaning? Thus he abides desanai, adimai madirirati, and mentality. Internally. Thus he avoids discerning ultimate materiality and mentality externally. Thus he avoids discerning ultimate materiality and mentality both internally and externally. There are two reasons. One reason is if you can discern ultimate materiality as well as ultimate mentality both internally and externally, at that time, you get this independent origination. Another reason is to contemplate as anicca, dukkha, anatta, both internally and externally. Usually we have attachment not only to ourselves, but also to external things. Is it true? You already understand.
Yeah.
So, the power of vipassana. If you can contemplate internal materiality and mentality as nature, dukkha, and anatta, then attachment to internal body disappears temporarily. If you can contemplate both internally and externally as nature, dukkha, and anatta, at that time only your inside knowledge can destroy attachment to both internally and externally. If the vipassana insight can destroy the defilements temporarily, other than only part inclusion knowledge can arrest at the end of mature insight knowledge. Other than only part knowledge can destroy the final is completely without remainder, stage by stage. So because of this reason, before discerning dependent origination, first you must try to discern ultimate materiality and mentality, both internally and externally. If there is no light of vajra, eye consciousness cannot see. Eye consciousness also can see just color only, but mind, which and eye, in different ways, many ways they can see. Mind, which and I can see ultimate, this is ultimate materiality, this is ultimate mentality, this is nature, this is dukkha, this is nada, etc. In different ways, many ways they can see. So, if you want to practice dependent origination to understand, you want direct knowledge, first you must try to discern ultimate mentality and materiality both internally and externally. If a meditator gets on this approximate path, past causes, then she should try to discern mentality and materiality but up to the conception stage. For example, she should try to discern this morning mentality, materiality, yesterday mentality, materiality, day before yesterday mentality, materiality, etc. Then up to the inside mother's womb, up to the conception stage or path linking mind movement stage. After discerning ultimate materiality and mentality in conception stage, in this very life, then a meditator must continue to discern mentality and materiality in previous existence, especially near death moment. Usually, in time of birth linking mind movement or conception stage, there are three types of materialities and the four types of mental formations. Three types of kalapas are body tagged kalapa, sat tagged kalapa, and heart tagged kalapa. In each kalapa, there are 10 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, life quality, and body transparency, or sex determining materiality, or heart tagged, heart base. After discerning this materiality and mentality, one should continue to discern ultimate materiality and mentality in previous life. According to Buddha's teaching, in previous life, last mind movement is called death consciousness mind movement. In this very life, first mind movement is called birth linking mind movement. Between these two mind movements, death consciousness mind movement and path linking mind movement, there is no gap. No interval life. Immediately after death consciousness finish, the path linking mind movement in this body life arise. Immediately must try to see these two types of mind movements. Then he should try to see death proximate object in previous life. I would like to explain with one example. A lady, when she descends that proximate object, she saw she is offering food to the Sangha. However, when offering food to the Sangha, she is not woman, she is bhikkhu. So, when she descends one by one, four elements in each person, other mentality and material are not one line to his, to her mentality and materiality. But when he, when she descends one bhikkhu, offering bhikkhu, offering, that his mentality and materiality are one line up to this present moment. Then I suggest her to descend actually while offering food, mentality and materiality. To descend mentality and materiality while she is really offering food to the Sangha. While offering food, she had no wish to be, to become woman and future existence. But she had one type of inclination for this problem. When visiting two different pagodas, on the way, accidentally, he saw one lady, very beautiful and with long hair. That lady's hair is very thick and very long. She is very beautiful.
아름다운 여성이었어요.
And then that bhikkhu has the desire to be like that lady.
This is, 바로 그때 그 비구는 이 여성과 같이 되고 싶다라는 욕망이 생겼습니다.
This is problem.
그것이 문제였던 거죠.
Then one day he offered to the food to the Sangha. When offering food, he had such memory.
그 음식을 공양할 때 그 기억이 났던 것입니다.
So he had inclination to be such a beautiful man, thick and long haired woman. One by moment, one by moment decide to become man or to become woman. If he knows beautiful woman with long hair, such understanding is wrong understanding. This wrong understanding is called avijja, ignorance. Depending on this ignorance, she had attachment to that woman's life. That attachment is called craving tanha. The repeated attachment is called clinging upadana. These three are the development rounds, kilesa upadana. So depending on this development round, she accumulate hosan karma. Which type of hosan karma? Offering food to the Sangha. While offering food to the Sangha, there are 34 mental formations. These 34 mental formations are called sankhara. But these sankharas are also anicca and permanent. As long as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. But they, when they pass away, perishing away, they left behind the karma potentiality, which can produce new existence. So altogether, there are five causes. Ignorance, craving, clinging, volitional informations and karma potentiality. So karma already exists. It is not easy to destroy. If you want to destroy this karma, then you must try to be arhat. Only arhat can destroy completely without remedy this karma potentiality. So altogether there are five causes already exist. Then these five causes become mature in the object. Because of the mature to this karma potentiality, in the object, this object appears again. This object means offering food to the Sangha, this object appears again. So, because of this karma potentiality, then if she tries to see causal relationship between cause and effect, then karma potentiality in this very life, 30 types of rupa materiality and then of birth maintain my moment. So she trying to see both sides, karma potentiality, here materiality, karma potentiality, materiality. Then This karma potentiality produces these 30 types of materiality she already sees. So, mind produces mind form materiality. In the same way, this karma also produces karma form materiality and then of God like my moment. After this only this cause and effect. She cried a lot. We could become woman, father's
wife.
Is it okay? Good? So one by moment is very important. While accumulating karma, if you cannot control your mind, this is problem. That lady in this very light, very thick and very long hair. Karma create this one. When she stand up, her hair is on the floor. Very long. Not your hair.
그녀는 이 생에서 정말 아름답고 삼단같이 두껍고.
So, karma is very wonderful. If you understand this divine origination, by your direct knowledge, at that time only, you can become real Buddhist. Why? You cannot change. Because you understand karma. You understand karma produces karma. Materiality and mentality. At the day, you will not accept there is creator, there is no karma, or there is no future existence, there is no past existence. Such type of wrong views will never arise to your mind. Buddha only teach there is cause, there is effect. But Buddha also teach because of the complete cessation of causes, aggregates also cease completely without reminder. That cessation is also called Nirodha Sitya, the cessation of suffering in the Thayana Sutta. Five causes we have already explained: ignorance, craving, clinging, formation, sankhara, original formations, and karma potentiality. Five aggregates rise. This is causal rising. Then causal cessation means because of the complete cessation of these five causes: ignorance, craving, clinging, original formations, and karma potentiality. The five aggregates cease completely without remainder. That complete cessation is because of Arahant path. Arahant path destroys all defilements, ignorance, craving, and clinging. Because of the complete cessation of these causes, then five aggregates after final cessation no more exist. That complete cessation only. But here, Buddha teaching is called Vibhijjavada. Vibhijjavada means because of this, this rise. Because of the cessation of this, this cease. In this way only. The destruction of the taste because is for those poor one who knows and sees. It is not for one who does not know and does not see. This is Buddha's teaching in Sicca Sanyuga, Aswakriya Sutra. I only recite that sutra in Pali. Is it okay?
괜찮습니까?
Jana doham bhikkhave pasato asvanakhiya vadami no ajana do no abhasato. Kincha bhikkhave jana do kin pasato asvanakhiya hodi. Idan do gani bhikkhu jana do pasado aswana kyo hodi. Ayan do ka sumudiyodi jana do pasado aswana kyo hodi. Ayan do ka niyododi jana do pasado aswana kyo hodi. Ayan do ka niyoda gamini vadibadadi jana do pasado aswana kyo hodi. Eung go bhikkhu jana do eung pasado aswana kyo hodi. Tasmadiha bhikkhave idam dukkham yogam karaniyo ayam dukkham samudayo yogam karaniyo ayam dukkham nirodho yogam karaniyo ayam dukkham nirodha gamini patipada yogam karaniyo.
ဣဒုမံကံပရိယောကိုတိတ္တိတံယုံသိစွာဖြင့်တယုလေအကြီးကံကိုသောတေတပ္ပိနာဘုံတော်ကုန်တော်ပါရာယဏိယောညေပါပကံပတ္တိအခကတိသုတိမေယံကုန်ခေဌာနဉာဏ်ရှင်ဒီဟောတုမောကပ္ပတေတိပါတိ
ဘုရားမူလီမောလီမီအမြဲပြသောအပရာဇိကံမြာကိုပြညာတော်ပြင်သက်တဲ့ယံတော်ယံဓမ္မမမဘောအုံးတော်မူပြီးတကယ်သောဘုရားမြေဝမြေဝပုံသဏ္ဍာန်ယိုဤကျိုးသာလေသံနေတံကိုယောတော်
ဒီစီဝရယံယကံဘောကောင်းရံတဏ္ဍာရောမြတ်ဝိသေဝိရောမမြတ်ပုညံနိဗ္ဗာန်ရည်ရှိသောသူတ္တစီကကြီးဝါကြီးရှိကြကုန်၏ဖြစ်၍ဒုက္ခိတကိုစိညပြညိချမ်းသာခြင်းသို့ရောက်ရှိကြကုန်၏ဖြစ်၍အဘိဟိမိမေပါပေသုတ္တေသောခန္ဓာကိုယ်သို့လောကောသောညာတိပိစံယောပေါင်းတို့နေသာသူတို့ဘုရားအရောကနရောကဒုက္ခကိဝေကြကုန်၏ ဒုက္ခိယကိုစိညပြညိချမ်းသာခြင်းရှိကြကုန်၏ဘောဓာတိကြပါစေကုန်သတည်း။အဘမင်္ဂလံကိုစိချမ်းသာခြင်းအကြောင်းကောင်းမြတ်သောခန္ဓာအသောလုံးသောမင်္ဂလာပေါင်းသည့်ဘောဓာတိဖြစ်ပါစေသတည်း။အဘဒီဝိနကံသင်္ကန်းနာမြတ်သောအပေါင်းတို့သည်ရက္ခဏ်တို့အမြဲတမ်းဆောင်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်း။အဘဗုဒ္ဓံဒီမဝိနကံကဝါလူသစ္စမကပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တို့ကြည့်ပေါ်သောသတိအသောလုံးသောဘောဓာတိယဉ်တို့၏
ဤပရိညာကိုသိကြသည်သာသို့သာသည်လျှင်ရှိကြကုန်သောသည်ဒုက္ခိယကိုသိကြသည်သာသို့သာသည်လျှင်ရှိကြကုန်သောသည်ရာဏီယဉ္ဇဘုဒ္ဓကမ္မဋ္ဌကခန္တိဒုက္ခိယကိုသိကြသည်သာသို့သာသည်လျှင်ရှိကြကုန်သောသည်ဘုဒ္ဓဖြစ်ကြပါသည်ကုန်သတည်း